Hi, my name is Amanda Lamb. I am a junior at Owen Drew Roberts High School, graduating class of 2016, and I play for Excalibur Field Hockey. I play goalie for both Excalibur and Owen Drew Roberts High School, and my goals for like the next few years would probably be to just keep improving on everything I do and just keep trying my hardest.
When we speak about Amanda, we think about a young lady who has grown immensely over the last 2 years. She does an exceptionally good job of communicating with her teammates, with her defenders in front of her. And I think that is key to organizing her defense. She is going to be the leader of that defensive unit. And so her communication skills will be key as she moves forward.
I feel the level of competition at Excalibur is a lot higher than it would be for a high school team, because you're not only playing against high-level teams, but you're also practicing with like amazing players all the time, and you always have amazing coaches there to help you.
Her biggest asset is her communication to her backfield players and getting them to see what's coming and trying to prepare to get the least angle for her to take as a shot. Her strengths are her athleticism and her speed.
She moves exceptionally well, covers space, covers angles exceptionally well. Her footwork is exceptional. She works really hard to continue improving her skills. Her receiving balls in the air, exceptional.
I think the coaching at Excalibur has helped me greatly, because they like push you hard, but they also make sure that you make the changes that you need to make yourself and that you learn from all of your mistakes. So they don't just tell you what you do wrong, they tell you what to fix, and you have to fix it yourself.
She's been with the high school team since her freshman year. She really worked hard to become the JV goalie behind two of very excellent varsity goalies, Allie Mooney and Liz Tamboro. She at any time could have jumped in her sophomore year and held her own, and she would have done well.
Being behind these two really amazing goalies, it was like an eye-opener to see how much effort and like how they always never give up and they always want to be there and have great attitudes. It was kind of showed me how good I could become. One of them goes to Ohio State and she actually starts, and she's only a freshman, and the other one starts for Shippensburg. I think it's pretty cool to be able to pass on what I learned from the other goalies and what I know myself to another person. It's like, I might want to be a teacher myself one day, and I like to know that I made a difference for somebody else, I guess. The importance of communicating as a goalie is a really big thing, because you always have to help your teammates out where they don't know what's going on and make sure everything's always covered, or if there's a passing lane they can't see. And it's always good to talk about that in like a positive way and encouraging them. With conditioning, I would say that I feel like I would have to actually do a little bit more than other players, because being a goalie, I feel that you have to be the most like athletic and in shape person there so that you can defend the goal at all times, no matter what. I kind of balance my schedule by like, I go to school every day. Then usually practice is not right after school, so I can come home, maybe eat a snack and relax a little bit, so that's like my relaxing time before practice. Then I go and practice and I do my best to practice. And then when I come home, I try and get all my homework done, maybe eat dinner, and then maybe if I need to study, I study after dinner. On weekends, that's usually when I can hang out with my friends. When I make a mistake, I usually try not to take it too hard. Most of the time, it's not bad. I just kind of use what I failed on and just make it so I can make myself better for next time and just gain more experience from it. I would describe myself as a teammate as someone who's like a little bit goofy sometimes, but like I love to be part of the team and I love to push my teammates too so they can get better. And like always make sure we're working together all the time and not trying to like everyone's doing their own things. That's not a team. My work ethic, I would say, is to always try my hardest, because if you try and you fail, you can say that you tried, and to always just always work for it no matter what.
Her strength has improved. When she came in, she had a lot of quickness but would get knocked over in front of the goal. Now she's gotten size and a little bit of muscle to that, and that quickness and that athleticism now has something to back it up.
I manage peer pressure in high school now by just kind of sticking to what I think I should do and what would be best for me, and a lot of my friends are like that too, so it's not hard to stick. stay with what I think. I think in terms of college, managing peer pressure probably wouldn't be difficult if I do play sport, because I will already be like wrapped up with sports and academics and maybe other activities that I'd want to do and not have time for it or feel that it's just not worth it. Some of the activities I do is I'm also a member of the softball team, and I also really enjoy snowboarding, and I actually just got a new snowboard too, which I'm ready to use that. I also am a member of the Anchor Club at Owen J. Roberts, and they are a club that does activities to help other people, like food drives or volunteering at elementary schools to like help out at bingos, stuff like that. I usually prefer to work with the kids because they're kind of cute and funny, and they're amusing, and it's kind of like fun to see them smile. What I have to offer as a player and as a student is I feel like I have a great attitude because I want to be there and I want to always be working hard and improve upon my skills.
For Amanda, her experience this year in high school will continue to hold her in good stead and then improve her ability to play at the next level.